We often refer to services that we are using on an everyday basis, such as airline reservation or Gmail or web surfing, as giant scale services, as opposed to the services that you get within your own organization, example, a file server. There's a later module in this course called Internet Scale Computing. And in that, we will discuss programming models and resource management issues for providing such giant scale services. The focus at this point, however, is to show how object technology facilitates structuring such services. Let's look at an example to put things in perspective. Let's say you want to purchase a round-trip ticket to go from Atlanta to Chennai, India. With a few clicks, you can send your request over to a portal such as Expedia. And Expedia then goes to work for you. It contacts a whole bunch of different airlines, gets the best options that are available from all these different choices, and then it comes back to you with a bunch of options. Now, you may take your own sweet time deciding which one of those you may want to pick based on cost, perhaps convenience, guarantees. For example, you don't want your baggage to end up in Timbuktu. So based on all of that, you may want to make a decision. Maybe you have to talk to your spouse or significant other, or siblings, children, so on, in order to make the final decision. Finally, you decide, then commit to buying the ticket, and then Expedia will complete the transaction based on the choice that you made, and you get your ticket and life is good. Well, not so fast. While you're busy procrastinating with your choices, there's another person who is planning almost an exact similar trip to yours, same date, same constraints, same destination, and so on. And you can immediately see that without your realizing, you are actually competing for resources. In this case, a physical resource, a seat on a particular flight going from Atlanta to Chennai, India, with others that you don't even know exist on this planet. Therefore, the service provider, in this case, multiple enterprises involved, Expedia and all the airlines together that are handling your request, they all have to work together to make sure that they resolve any resource conflict that might occur between simultaneous requests across space and time coming from several different clients. So all the issues that we have discussed in the context of parallel and distributed systems, synchronization, communication, atomicity of actions, concurrency, all of these become important and they surface in this very simple example across space and time. And additionally, all services need some common features, for example, a shopping cart on your browser. And in fact, even though this particular example is illustrating an airline reservation, if it comes to booking a ticket on a train, or getting hotel reservation or booking tickets to go see a game, all of those things have similar requirements, and many of them are probably repeatable, and many of them, such as the shopping cart in this example, are features that might be needed even if the services that we're talking about are completely different, such as an airline reservation and hotel booking. So since the same issues crop up in the implementation of each new service, we don't want to reinvent the wheel every time. This is where object technology comes in, the power of reuse of components.